Well, good evening and welcome to the Ritz Theater. My name is Sarah Efforts. I'm the executive director of the Scranton Jazz Festival. And I'd like to thank you so much for joining us tonight for this special holiday celebration. That is, yes, thank you. And now that it is our second year in a row, we can say it's a holiday tradition. Your continued support of our programs is so greatly appreciated, and it's so essential for us to continue to bring award-winning musicians together for our community to enjoy. I'd like to offer just a quick special thanks to all of our media partners and sponsors who've helped make this event tonight possible, of which have been displayed and recognized on the screens this evening, as you saw earlier. I'd also like to thank the Ritz Theater for being our host, and congratulations on celebrating nearly 110 years of this building. And it's such a beautiful and historic and perfect venue to host our students and also the big band later tonight. And if walls could talk, I'm sure that they'd share many stories of some of the most iconic jazz musicians and performers who graced this stage, and we're honored to bring more award-winning jazz back to this stage to build on its history for years to come. So to get us started tonight, we have a very special performance from the PA Jazz Institute students. The PA Jazz Institute is the educational wing for the Scranton Jazz Festival and has been providing jazz education in Northeast Pennsylvania for 25 years. Founded by Marco Marcinko, the PA Jazz Institute recruits and offers scholarship opportunities for young musicians, and tonight you'll get to hear this jazz combo play a few of our holiday favorites. These students rehearsed for the past 3 weeks. I say day and night. Did it feel like day and night? They were receiving expert instruction by multiple professors of Dave Jumper, Steve Carilla, Kate Anderson, Jim Buckley, and Marco Marcinko. And tonight, they are being directed by Steve Carilla. So we welcome to the stage the PA Jazz student combo. You good? All right, and with that, we say take it away.
All right, I'd like to introduce the ensemble. We've got, why don't you stand when you hear your name? We've got Fred on trumpet. We've got Bryce Miller on alto sax. Antonio Torres on tenor sax. AJ Bell on barry. Adam Jonkman on tenor sax. Got Ben Worrell on piano. Got Seth on bass. And we've got Patrick Marcinko on the drums. And our third and final number of the evening, Frosty the Snowman.
Thank you.
So as I mentioned briefly before, this is our second year hosting this holiday fundraising event. Last year, through the generosity of our community, we were able to donate over 100 toys to the Children's Advocacy Center of NEPA. And we're very thrilled to be able to do the same this year. So thank you to everyone here in the audience and in our community who had dropped off previously for your contributions and support for these children. This event also helps raise support to present what will be the 18th annual Scranton Jazz Festival this summer. We're going on 18 years in this city. Isn't that awesome? So last year's event, hopefully you were all there, but if you happened to miss it, you know, if you decided to go on a vacation and just chose the wrong dates to be gone the first weekend in August, or you were at the beach somewhere, next time, make sure you're here the first week in August. But we had over 80 musicians that we were able to employ for that weekend, and over 22 venues in downtown Scranton were involved, which was a record for us to have that level of involvement. We were also able to bring back two headlining acts, which we hadn't been able to do since the pandemic, which took place on this very stage. So if you were here, you know what an epic, epic night or two nights that was, with the four freshmen, and it was just a fantastic show. And so mark your calendars for August 4, 5, and 6 this summer. You won't want to miss what we have in store for you. With your support, we're able to continue the tradition and build upon it year after year. So visit our website at scrantonjazzfestival.org for upcoming show announcements, ways to volunteer if you'd like, and as well as opportunities to sponsor or make a donation. All right, that's my PSA for the night. I swear I'm done. Are you guys ready to continue the show? All right. So I have the honor to introduce you to tonight's narrators, our beloved and talented Scranton Jazz Festival MC for the past 14 years, Mr. Lawrence Pugliese. As well as WBRE personality and local celebrity that you all may know, Paula Gin Giacomo. Will you please welcome them to the stage?
I'm Paula Gin Giacomo. Thank you for being here. I'm from WBRE and the Eyewitness News team. And as a special assignment reporter, I have quite an interesting and fulfilling job as a journalist. But tonight, I get a break from all of that to talk about music, jazz music to be precise. I'm honored to be here tonight with Larry to showcase the Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band under the direction of the talented Marco Marcinko. And artistic director, I might add. How many of you attended the Scranton Jazz Festival last summer? Isn't that a wonderful event that gets the entire Electric City buzzing? Well, perhaps you were able to see this great big band perform with the legendary Four Freshmen vocal group. It sure was a fantastic weekend in downtown Scranton, and we want to thank the Ritz Theater for opening its doors to this amazing holiday event and to this award-winning, Emmy-nominated Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band. Tonight, you will hear all of your Nutcracker favorites, but with a jazzy twist. Last year, we had the Ritz Theater totally rocking and rolling, so you are in for a treat tonight. Isn't that right, Lauren?
Yes, indeed, Paula. Thank you. Paula Gin Giacomo, Sarah, thank you for the introduction as well. And it's so nice to be with you here again this holiday season. And we're going to have a wonderful evening together. Do you know what Peter Tchaikovsky, Shorty Rogers, Duke Ellington, and Bill Strayhorn have in common? Anybody? Music, yes. Composers, arrangers, they all are. And tonight you're going to hear the incredible melodies of Pete Tchaikovsky, as we like to call him, reimagined by jazz masters Shorty Rogers, Duke Ellington, and Billy Strayhorn. Billy Strayhorn, back in 1960, along with Duke Ellington, started working on their re-sort of thinking of the Nutcracker songs that you all have come to know and love. At the same time, so was Shorty Rogers working on it. In the same place, back in May of 1960, out in California. They were only several minutes away from each other in two separate studios. Duke and Billy were at Radio Recorders in West Hollywood, and Shorty was at RCA Victor's Music in Los Angeles, California. We don't know if the two major labels caught wind of the others trying to put together the Nutcracker in a jazz sort of milieu, and we're not sure if they then try to rush and get the best jazz musicians they could find in the studio so they can compete. That's all conjecture at this point. But regardless, what we have today, because of it, are amazing jazz versions of the Sugar Plum Fairy, Waltz of the Flowers, the Arabian Dance, and the Tea Dance, to name but a few. So, our sort of respect and love and interpretation of all of that here for you tonight. Without further ado, here is the wonderful Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band under the direction of Artistic Director Marco Marcenko playing the overture arranged by Billy Strayhorn. Take it away. The next two selections are variations of Tchaikovsky's March. Duke Ellington refers to March as, quote, Peanut Brittle Brigade March is the Duke's title. It is very intense and a hard swinger. Shorty Rogers refers to his version as a nutty march, and the contrast of the two are quite tantalizing. So here they are now. You're going to hear them back to back. Thank you. The Scranton Jazz Festival, big band. The next two selections are reimagined versions of The Waltz of the Snowflakes and The Arabian Dance. Shorty Rogers took both selections and retitled them Snowball and Dance Espresso. Notice that Snowball is no longer a waltz, and Dance Espresso features the upright bass, Paul Rostock, with the sax section featuring Tommy Hamilton, my good friend. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band. Thank you.
So what do you think of the band so far? Pretty awesome, right? This 17-piece jazz big band with four trumpets, four trombones, six saxophones, piano, bass, and drums. Many instruments weaving notes together to create one distinct sound. It is not every day you see this talent in Northeastern PA, and what a pleasure it is to see this big band perform live in front of an audience, playing tunes that appeal to a multiple generations. Well, the Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band is a huge asset to our area, and it definitely has the Electric City buzzing tonight. The next selection is the famous tea dance. However, the tea dance takes on a whole new brew, and Shorty calls it Chinaware. Now, the melody is hidden deep inside the reharmonization of the original chord structure. The tempo feels like a 1960s Las Vegas show, and the whole big band just roars. Let's hear it.
Thank you so much. Well, now we're going to get into a Russian dance, or trepak. It was called Kazatsky. I think I got the pronunciation correct. In the Tchaikovsky original, it is transformed here into a fast-paced piece in 8-8 time, divided up as a 3-3-2 in each bar at the outset, then 6-4 time for the principal melody. Everybody understand that now? You have your tape measure? After the trumpet quotes the melody, a Latin-inspired groove pushes the band along. The trombones take center stage in this selection Shorty calls Six Pack. And away we go. Thank you.
From a Latin groove to a blues feel. Dance of the Reed Flutes or Dance of the Mirlitons, whichever you might prefer. Shorty calls this Blue Reeds, and it really shows off an incredible swinging blues feel. Listen to the saxophones and the displaced rhythms with the brass section playing a double time figure behind each soloist. Waltz of the Flowers is a standard waltz as written by Tchaikovsky. However, Flowers for the Cats has a real toe-tapping feel with a little title alone makes you think you're in a cool jazz club atmosphere filled with those really cool cats in dark sunglasses and berets. So let's take a listen to this one.
Thank you. Thank you.
That was sweet. That was sweet. Thank you. Scranton Jazz Festival, big band. Pas de deux. This particular selection is not as popular a theme as others we've heard this evening. Shorty ramps the tempo way up to produce a high-pressure swinger. Probably in great respect to Ellington, he affectionately calls it Pass the Duke. The Sugar Plum Fairy, which is now called the Swinging Plum Fairy, is a straight-ahead medium swing that features the saxes with muted trumpet. The melody appears in the upright bass, and how nicely it emulates that West Coast jazzy sound that Shorty Rogers helped to create. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band. Thank you.
Now we'll do Overture in Miniature, or Overture for Shorty. It's a sax quintet feature with trumpet and rhythm section that quotes the melody and gives the listener the feeling that it is merely a standard jazz tune.
Thank you. Those guys can swing. Hello, everyone. My name is Gina Savoda. I'm from Veterans Views on WBRE, and I have been a longtime committee member with the Scranton Jazz Fest. In the spirit of giving, tonight we are supporting children in our community by collecting new toys, which will hopefully bring smiles to their faces and hope to their hearts. The Children's Advocacy Center of Northeastern Pennsylvania is a private, nonprofit, charitable organization whose mission is to provide excellence in the assessment and treatment of child abuse and neglect. Children's Advocacy Center NEPA provides medical assessments and child forensic interviews, and also coordinates a team response to child abuse and neglect in Northeastern Pennsylvania. This makes a situation that could be so difficult for a child a little bit better. And by your gift that you gave tonight, it'll make it even that much more better. The work they do in our community is so vital, so thank you for bringing some joy to the children they serve. Thank you also for supporting the Scranton Jazz Festival and for being with us tonight. Please welcome back to the stage Larry, Paula, and Sarah.
Thank you so much, Gina. And thank you to our Ritz Theater hosts, Michael and Sherry Melcher, to Taryn Coulter, who's up there managing the tech tonight, and the entire Ritz Theater staff for all that you do to support the arts. Thank you, Ritz. Larry and Paula, will you stand and join me here for a moment? Let's give another warm round of applause to our wonderful narrators, Paula Giacomo, Larry Pugliese. Take a bow. Thank you. And well, what an amazing show this was tonight. If that doesn't get you in the holiday spirit, then I don't know what will. I'm ready for tinsel and Christmas cookies and Santa. But put your hands together for the Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band and Artistic Director Marco Marcinko. And Marco, will you please introduce the amazing people you have on stage with you tonight?
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Miss Sarah Effert, please. Thank you so much for being here. Great crowd. Nice right after all that turkey on Thursday that we get you to come out on a Sunday. I'm sorry you're missing a football game, but we're supporting the arts here. It's all good. So on the very end there in the sax section, you're going to see that very large instrument, and that's a bass saxophone. And during the course of the year, a family of mice usually lives inside the bell. That's Mr. Mike Pryor on bass saxophone. And sitting right next to Mr. Mike Pryor, big band in the Scranton area wouldn't be complete without this gentleman. That's James Buckley III, Esquire. Our very good friend and the jazz director in Toledo, Ohio. He lives in the Westchester area. We've been longtime friends, and he's a brilliant musician. And this is Gunnar Mossblad on tenor sax and clarinet. Playing lead alto and clarinet and first tenor for all the Shorty Rogers arrangements, the great Nelson Hill. And this young lady is the, I say young because she's the youngest person in the band, so it's nice not to be the young one anymore. I'm sort of in the middle now. And this is one of my students, and one of the great saxophone players that's up and coming, and you're gonna hear a lot more from her. This is Miss Kate Anderson. Right here on the tenor saxophone, you heard him solo a few times, and we've been playing together over 30 years, and I always have to introduce him the right way. This is Tommy Mustachio Cha-Cha Hamilton. In the trombone section to my immediate left, coming up from the Allentown area, the brilliant trombonist, Bill Smith. Sitting right next to Bill, if ever you get a chance to see the Spanish Harlem Orchestra, you'll see this man playing trombone and doing a lot of the arranging and writing. Multi-Grammy Award winning trombonist Doug Beavers. And sitting right next to Doug, he usually brings a lot more instruments than he did. What, did you just bring the superbone tonight? Oh, and a trumpet, okay. He usually has a French horn, a baritone horn, and a mess of stuff. I think Mark probably got mad at you and said he needs a little more room on stage, so. The incredible multi-instrumentalist, this is Jeff Stockham. And then every band has its own Santa Claus, and we are no exception, and this gentleman who plays the role quite well during the season, also is the master of the bass trombone and many, many years teaching students at Penn State University and Woody Herman's band, Frank Sinatra's band, and so many others, the great Mark Lusk. Back here in the trumpet section, his first time playing with us on fourth trumpet. Put your hands together for Ken Lucky. Sitting right next to Ken, coming up from the Harrisburg area, Mr. Bill Perbetsky. On lead trumpet, we do it every year with them. This is Dr. Eddie Severn. Ho, ho, ho. Right here on second trumpet, the great jazz trumpeter moved here during the pandemic from New York. We're very happy he's in the Poconos now. This is the great Chris Rogers. This gentleman on bass is from Pittston, PA. Pittston, PA. Where's Rose? Pittston, PA. All right, Rose. Played with Frank Sinatra Jr. for over 40 years, as well as living in the Poconos, playing with Phil Woods and Zoot Sims and Herbie Green and a whole bunch of characters. This is the great Paul Rostock on bass. And this gentleman on the electric keyboard, he is jazz in Central Pennsylvania. He's one of the founders of the Central Pennsylvania Friends of Jazz. And when I was 18 years old, he invited me to drive down. I just got my license, and he said, now that you got your license, why don't you come down and play some gigs with me? And I've been playing with him ever since, and now he's up here playing with this band, and that's the great Steve Rudolph. Yours truly, Marco Marcenko. Thank you. So a thank you to our sponsors, Fidelity Bank, Toyota of Scranton, please. King Outdoor, Jerry Frank, King Outdoor, Frank's News. Give it up. Jerry, you here somewhere? There he is. Put your hands together for Jerry Frank, King Outdoor. Blue Elefante Event Center, City Print, Bold Gold Media, Scranton Tomorrow, Chiaroscuro Records, WVIA and WBRE, Lackawanna County, and of course the PA Jazz Alliance. Our Scranton Jazz Festival needs sponsorships, needs people to come out and get tickets and do whatever you can to help us out, because we want to continue on with the 18th annual Scranton Jazz Festival the first weekend of August. Thank you. So, Larry, did you just, I think you just said, I forgot one of the band members. I forgot one of the band members. He wasn't able to make rehearsal this afternoon, but he said he was gonna come and do a special number with the band tonight. Let's bring him out, Santa Claus. Santa, would you like to say a few words?
Sure.
Go ahead.
How about this band?
Thank you, Santa.
This was absolutely wonderful. Now, the audience, they're fantastic. They get applause all night. You collected toys. You brought toys in. And that's very much appreciated. It's just really appreciated. And I applaud you.
Santa Claus, ladies and gentlemen. Would you like to hear one more, or you just want to go home? One more? You want to hear one more? Are you guys into doing one more? What do you say? Yeah? Well, this one, we had it planned, you know that. This one is not associated with a nutcracker, but it is a holiday classic that you will recognize, arranged by Marco Marcenko and played by the Emmy-nominated Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band. Here is Noel's Jingle. Thank you, happy holidays, and we'll see you in August.
Thank you, Scranton Jazz Festival Big Band. Thank you, family and friends. Thank you, everyone that came out. Happy holidays. Thanks, band. Thank you, band. Thank you, guys. Thank you, narrators. Thank you, Gina. Thank you, Sarah.